Hello students, so in this video we will start our reading from the line, last second line on page number 27. As you know, this description is of William O. Douglas, and he shares his personal experience of fear with us and how he overcame that fear in his life. So when he was in the pool at YMCA, so he was very much afraid because a bruiser boy, he just pushed him into the water. And after that he was feeling very nervous, and whenever he would go to water, then he would feel very much nervous, and his stomach would become sick. And that fear remained with him forever. For a long time, not forever, for a long time. Whenever he went to Titan, Bumping River, to bathe in it, went to Warm Lake, etc., then an icy horror, a dangerous horror, would grab his heart. So this remained with him for a long time. So this handicap stayed with me as the years rolled by. Years rolled by, many years rolled by, बहुत साल बीत गए, but still that handicap, that disability stayed with him for a long time. In canoes on main lakes, even he went in flatboat, canoe means flatboat, on main lakes fishing for landlocked salmon. Landlocked salmon is a type of fish which is found at the bank of the river. So whenever he go for any sort of fishing, then he could not enjoy that because he was afraid of water. Whenever he went for bass fishing in New Hampshire, it was a big lake. It is a big lake in USA. Trout fishing, it is also a type of fish, trout, on the Massachusetts and Metolius in Oregon. These are the places at USA, in USA. Fishing for salmon on the Columbia, whenever he went to Columbia River for salmon fishing, at Bumping Lake in the Cascades hote hain, jo chakravat jo hote hain. Wherever I went, the haunting fear of the water followed me. So wherever he went, that haunting fear, that fear which used to come again and again, that followed him everywhere. So it remained with him for a long time. It ruined my fishing trips, deprived me of the joy of canoeing, boating and swimming. So this fear ruined all his fishing trips. Whenever he went for fishing, this fear, that fear ruined his trips. And it deprived him from the joy of canoeing. Canoeing means to sail in a flat boat, boating and swimming. So ye cheeze wo enjoy nahi kar paya, and he was deprived of, vanchit raha wo खुशियों से. I used every way I knew to overcome this fear, but it held me firmly in its grip. Even he tried very much for this, as he knew that that was the best way to overcome his fear, but it held him firmly. लेकिन इस डर ने उसको इतना जकड़ा हुआ था, इतना ज्यादा वो डर था कि वो चाहकर भी उस डर को दूर नहीं कर पाया. Finally, 1 October, and finally, what did he decide? On 1 October, I decided to get an instructor and learn to swim. So finally, he decided that he would hire an instructor and learn to swim. I went to a pool. So for that, he went to the pool. He went to a pool. This is not the same pool which was at YMCA. That was another pool. And he went to YMCA pool when he was 10 or 11 years old. But now he went to another pool and he hired an instructor to learn swimming and practiced 5 days a week. And he started practicing 5 days a week, an hour each day. And he did his practice an hour each day, because it is very, this exercise, it gives much exertion. That's why 1 hour is enough. The instructor put a belt around me, a rope attached. This paragraph is very important. There will be a question on it. And the question will be, how did the instructor build a good swimmer out of Douglas. So how the instructor helped him, it is mentioned in this paragraph. So put it in bracket, okay? The instructor put a belt around me. A rope attached to the belt went through a pulley that ran on an overhead big cable. What did the instructor do? He just put a belt around him. He just bound him with a belt. A rope attached to the belt, and there was a rope which was attached to the belt, went through a pulley, and this rope used to come through a pulley. Pulley jo hota hai, ek block hota hai, ek tarah ki ghirni hoti hai. Normally it is, you can see it on wells, jo kuwe hote hain unme jo pani khichne ke liye jo pulley use kiya jata hai na, that ran on an overhead cable. He held on to the end of the rope. And what did the instructor do? He held one end of the rope in his hand. And we went back and forth. And after that, they went back and forth. Aage peeche har par jaate the wo. Back and forth across the pool. Okay? Hour after hour. And they did it hour after hour. Day after day. Week after week. So they practiced for many weeks. On each trip across the pool, a bit of the panic seized me. Whenever he went, he was in water, and whenever he went back and forth of the pool, a panic, a fear seized him. It took over him. Each time the instructor relaxed his hold on the rope and I went under, some of the old terror returned and my legs froze. Whenever the instructor relaxed his hold, then he felt terror, and that terror, old terror, returned. And his legs froze, uske pair jam jate, they became hard. It was 3 months before the tension began to slack. Slack means to slow, to become slow. And it was just 3 months before when he shared his experience with all of us, when he wrote this experience. It was 3 months before of that writing. So the tension began to slack. तो उसका जो टेंशन था वो कम होने लगा. Then he taught me to put my face under and exhale. Then the instructor taught him how to exhale, how to inhale. So he taught him how to put face under water and exhale. कि पानी के अंदर कैसे रहना है और सांस कैसे छोड़ना है. And to raise his nose and inhale. और कैसे नाक ऊपर उठाना है और सांस को खींचना है. It is very difficult in water because I repeated the exercise hundreds of times. Bit by bit, I shed part of the panic that seized me when my head went under water. So he repeated that exercise hundreds of times. So he did much hard work. Bit by bit, thoda thoda karke, I shed part of the panic. And finally, he left. Shed part means he left that fear of panic. He left that fear. That seized him when his head went under water. तो जब भी उसका सिर अंदर जाता था पानी के, earlier he was afraid, and that fear seized him. But bit by bit he left that fear. Next he held. So this paragraph is very important. Next he held me at the side of the pool and had me kick with my legs. So this was the another part of his learning. So next, the instructor, he held him at the side of the pool and had him kick with his legs. He taught him how to kick with his legs in water. 4 weeks I did just that. 4 weeks the narrator practiced for that. At first, my legs refused to work. In the beginning, he was not comfortable with it. Earlier, his legs refused to work because they became hard in water. But they gradually relaxed. But bit by bit, they gradually means slowly, slowly. So gradually they became relaxed, and finally I could command them, and finally he could command his legs. So finally he learned how to command his legs in water. So in this way the instructor, he taught him how to swim. He helped him. Thus piece by piece he built a swimmer. So in this way piece by piece the instructor built a swimmer out of Douglas. There will be a long answer type question on it. And when he had perfected each piece, he put them together into an integrated whole. So when he perfected me in each piece, he just combined them all. He integrated them in whole. एक एक हिस्से में उसने पूरा सारी activities को combine कर दिया. In a prayer, he said, "Now you can swim, dive off and swim the length of the pool, crawl strong." And in April, William O'Douglas started learning swimming in October. But he could swim in April perfectly. So then the instructor said that he could swim and he asked him to dive off in water and swim the length of the pool, ki pura length cross kare pool ka, and he asked him to show crawl stroke, ring kar jane wala jo stroke, jo activity thi na, wo karte hue usko paar karna tha. I did, the instructor was finished and William O'Douglas did that. And the work of the instructor was finished. It doesn't mean the instructor was finished. That means his work was finished. But I was not finished. So in this way, but William O'Douglas' work was not finished yet. Why? Because he was still not satisfied. Because he wanted to overcome his fear completely. He could swim after instructor's teaching. But still, he was not completely satisfied. I still wondered if I would be terror-stricken when I was alone in the pool. Still, he was afraid that if he would be alone in the pool, aisa to nahi hoga, usko dar lagega pool ke andar, he would be afraid. I tried it. I swam the length up and down. So William Douglas, he tried it. He tried to, and he decided to go to swim in the pool alone. He swam the length up and down because earlier he had confidence that the swimmer would help him. But now he wanted to do it alone. He swam the length up and down. Tiny vestige of the old terror would return. Vestige hota hai, shadow. Thodi bhot parchhai, purane dar ki, loti. It means he became afraid a little bit. But now I could frown and say to that terror. But now he could frown, he could challenge that fear and say to that terror, "Trying to scare me? Well, here's to you, look." And off I would go for another length of the pool. So this is the challenging sentence. These words are told by William O'Douglas to that terror which he had in his heart. So he asked the fear, "Trying to scare me?" It means the terror was trying to scare him. So he challenged that terror and he just took over that fear. And after that, he went for another length of the pool. This went on until July, and he practiced like this until July. For April, May, June, July, for almost 4 months. He practiced. But I was still not satisfied. I was not sure that all the terror had left. Still he was not satisfied about this. Even he could swim very well in the pool. But still he was not satisfied because he wanted to overcome his fear completely. So he wanted to face that challenge. He wanted to remove that fear forever. I was not sure that all the terror had left. Still he was not sure that all the terror had left. So I went to Lake Wentworth in New Hampshire. So he went to Lake Wentworth in New Hampshire. It is a lake in New Hampshire. It is in USA. Dived off a dock at Triggs Island. So it was at Triggs Island. He dived off a dock. Dock means jahan pe jo boats ikatthi khadi hoti, nauka ghat. At Triggs Island. So there was an island named Triggs Island and swam 2 miles and he crossed 2 miles across the lake to Stampact Island and he went to another island named Stampact Island. He learned these names of islands and lakes also. I swam the crawl, breaststroke, side stroke and back. He just tried all the strokes which were taught to him by the instructor. Only once did the terror return when I was in the middle of the lake. I put my face under and saw nothing but bottomless water. The old sensation, that old feeling returned in miniature at a mini scale. So he when he was in the lake, once that terror returned, when he was in the middle of lake. But he put his face under, and he could see only bottomless water. That feeling of fear returned at a small scale. But he laughed and said, and he again challenged that fear. What did he say? "Well, Mr. Terror, what do you think you can do to me?" He challenged by saying that terror could not do anything of him. So after that, when he gained confidence, it doesn't mean that he said this to that terror, but he gained confidence. He told so to himself. It fled and I swam on. So after that terror from his heart fled. Flee means bhag jana. So it is the second form. So it fled and I swam on. So after that terror fled. Udar jo hai wo bhag gaya and he swam on. Aur wo to tairta raha. Yet I had residual doubts. At my first opportunity, I hurried west, went up to Titan to Conrad Meadows, up the Conrad Creek Trail to Mead Glacier, and camped in the high meadow by the side of Warm Lake. After that, still he had residual doubts. Residuals, जो बचे हुए होते हैं, अभी भी कुछ doubt उसको बचे हुए थे. At my first opportunity, when he got the first opportunity, he hurried west, वो जल्दी करके west की तरफ गया. Went up the Titan to Conrad Meadows, खुले मैदानों में Titan to Conrad, जो खेत खलियान, the open fields which has patches of green grass. Up the Conrad Creek Trail to Mead Glacier तक गया. These are the names of the glacier and Conrad Creek Trail माने पगडंडी. And camped in the high meadow by the side of Warm Lake. And he camped. Camp लगाया उसने. In the high meadow by the side of, which was at the side of Warm Lake. The next morning I stripped. Next morning he stripped. Stripped means unclothed. Dived into the lake. Again he dived into the lake and swam across to the another shore and back. And he went to another shore and came back. He did all these things to overcome his fear completely. Just as Duff Corpron used to do. So he was a big swimmer of that type. That's why he said so. Used to do. I shouted with joy and Gilbert Peak returned the echo. So after that, when he was able to do so, even when he was able to swim across that lake, then he just shouted with joy because he was very happy, because he was successful in it. And when he shouted that Gilbert Peak, there was a peak named Gilbert, reached the echo, returned the echo. क्योंकि ऐसा होता है ना, जब पर्वतों पे के आसपास हम चिल्लाते तो वो आवाज इको होती है. I had conquered my fear of water. So finally he got victory over his fear of water. Conquer means victory. The experience had a deep meaning for me, as only those who have known stark terror and conquered it can appreciate. So that experience, it had a deep meaning for him. It gave a very, very deep impression on him forever. As only who have known stark terror. And this feeling can be felt by only those who know what is a stark terror, who have a stark terror in their life and conquered it, and who have conquered it, who got victory over it. They can understand. It can appreciate. Only they can appreciate. वही उसकी प्रशंसा कर सकते हैं जिन्होंने इस तरह का fear face किया हो और उस पर जीत पाई हो. In death there is peace. It is true that death, in death there is peace. There is terror only the fear of death. हम मृत्यु से डरते हैं लेकिन मृत्यु शांत होती है. तो जब तक मृत्यु नहीं होती तब तक हम डरते रहते हैं. In the same way, whenever we have a fear, we are very much afraid. But when we face that fear, all the fears are removed. As Roosevelt knew when he said, Roosevelt also said, all we have to fear is fear itself. Dar ke naam mein hi dar hai. Because I had experienced both the sensation of dying and the terror that fear of it can produce. As the narrator, he had experienced both the sensation, the feeling of dying, because he drowned in the swimming pool earlier, and the terror that fear of it can produce. And when he was dying at that time, He felt a terrible terror which was produced at that time. The will to live somehow grew in intensity. And when he faced that fear, then his will to live somehow grew in intensity. Intensity means gehrai se. Tab uski jo jeene ki ichha hai wo aur bhi badh gayi. So the person who faces fear, his will power of living becomes stronger. At last I felt released. Finally he felt released, free to walk the trails, and he was happy. He was feeling free. He was feeling the sense of freedom when he was walking the trails and climbed the peaks. Jab un pagdandiyon pe chadh raha tha wahan warm lake ke side mein, and he was climbing the peaks fearlessly and to brush aside fear, and he ignored that fear. He kept that fear aside. So finally he was very happy because he had overcome his fear of water. So the main thing, the main idea is, if we have a fear in our life, then there is a need to face that fear, to overcome that fear. So if we have a fear, then the best way to remove that fear is to face that fear and to get victory over it. Thank you.